scalloped potatoes. You're gonna end up using 2 boxes for this. You're gonna top that with some Colby Jack cheese. Now you're gonna take some fresh pork chops, and those are gonna go directly on top of our scalloped potatoes. There we go. Now you're gonna take 1 10-ounce can of cream of mushroom soup. Perfect. And to that, we're gonna add that packet of seasoning mix that came with the scalloped potatoes. You'll have 2 since we use 2 boxes. And then we're gonna add 2.5 cups of milk. And I also need some sour cream. There's some in the fridge. Would you grab that for me,
please? Sour cream, sure.
There it is. Sour cream right here, light.
Thank you. We're gonna end up using 1/2 cup of sour cream as well. We're gonna go ahead and start to mix this up. And now you're gonna take about 1/2 cup of sour cream. All right, we got that mixed up thoroughly. Now we're gonna take this liquid and pour it right on top. Just like that. We're gonna make sure it covers everything. Get it saturating our pork and all over the potatoes. All right, now it's ready to go in the oven. I've got it preheated to 400 degrees, and we're gonna cook this for about 30 minutes because these pork chops are nice and thin. But if you've got thicker chops, we'll cook it a little bit longer. We've still got 1 more yummy ingredient to go on top. While that's baking, Jax and I wanna see if you can get the riddle of the day right. What goes up and down the stairs without moving? Let us know what your guesses are on this one, but first tell us where you're from, then give us your guess. I'll be reading the comments. I'll let you know if you got it right. We'll be putting the answer there. Give it your best shot. Jax, do you know the answer to this one? No? Let's see if they do. All right, our pork chop casserole is almost done. It's only got about 5 more minutes to bake. We're gonna add some of these crispy French fried onions to the top.
Wait, those are good. I'm gonna try one.
They're good, aren't they?
Mm-hmm.
Sprinkle a few of these on there, right on top. Just for the last 5 minutes or so, and then we're gonna taste test our casserole. All right, our casserole is ready for the taste test. I can't wait to try this one. Look at that.
That looks great.
Those crispy onions look perfect. Now we've got our scalloped potatoes. They're nice and cheesy. We've got our cream of mushroom soup, but if you don't like those, you can make your own. Of course, we've got our pork chops. I'm just gonna go right in and dig in and get this one out right here. Nice and creamy potatoes.
Oh, so
look at that,
close.
We got it nice and steamy. I lost some onions there. Those potatoes are cooked nicely though. And there's our pork.
Okay.
I'm gonna fish out some of these crispy onions because I like those. There's your first bite of the pork.
Wow, this is good.
We have a winner. Add 2 cups of instant rice. I'm using brown rice, but you can use white rice if you want. And we're gonna add 2 cans of cream of chicken soup. Dump that right in. You're gonna take one of those cans and pour in some chicken broth, filling that can up. And then we're gonna add that on top of everything. Add about 1/2 cup of chopped onion. And now you're just gonna go in and mix everything up. Give it a nice mix so that all of our rice gets saturated with the cream of chicken soup and the broth. Now we're gonna take 3 fresh chicken breasts. We're just gonna lay that directly on top of our rice mixture. Here we go. Now I'm gonna season our chicken using this roasted garlic and herb. You can use whatever seasoning you want. Now you're gonna just top that with some frozen broccoli. Now y'all do not try to shame me for using frozen broccoli because frozen veggies are actually healthier than fresh in most cases. I know it sounds crazy, but it's true. You can look it up, I'm not lying to you. We're just gonna spread that broccoli out. You know what else we need? Some cheese.
Some cheese.
Would you get some from the fridge,
please? That cheese. Here it is. Colby Jack.
Thank you. Now you're just gonna sprinkle that cheese directly on top. Now, I'm using the bag cheese because this page is themed for quick and easy recipes, but you know, you can modify it. You can shred your own cheese. You can milk your own cow and make your cheese if you want to. Don't think that it has to be exactly the same that we're doing. Now we're gonna cover that with foil, and we're gonna pop that in the oven. I've got it preheated to 350 degrees, Now, because I use the instant rice, it's gonna cook a lot quicker. We're gonna do about 30 to 45 minutes at 350 degrees. But if you're using regular rice, you're gonna wanna go closer to an hour. All right, we're about to taste test, but first it's time for the riddle of the day. Let's see if you can get this one right. What will you actually find at the end of every rainbow? This is a tricky one. We're gonna see if you can get it right, but I want you to tell us where you're from in the comments and then tell us what your guess is. Take a look the next day and I'll tell you if you got it right. All right, it's time to taste test. This one's gonna be yummy. I love stuff and bake dishes like this because they are so easy. These are perfect for those nights when you don't have a lot of time, you just need to throw something together to avoid going through the drive-thru. Remember, you can modify the recipe, but for this one, wow, doesn't that look good? For this one, we have our rice. I used an instant brown rice. We also have some cream of chicken soup, some seasoning, broccoli, some nice big chicken breasts, and we also top those with some seasoning.
You like chicken breasts.
Of course you do. You ready to taste test this?
I am surely ready to taste test.
Looks good. All right, I'm gonna get a nice big scoop. We got our broccoli. Oh, that looks good. And look at that steam coming off. This is piping hot. That rice looks perfect. But if you're somebody that's worried about the sodium content, then you should probably use the healthy request version of the soups, reduced sodium chicken broth. There's swaps that you can make to make this healthier. Kyle, we're gonna try this one. You coming in?
Yeah, absolutely. Chicken, cheese, and rice.
And broccoli.
And broccoli.
Because it's healthy. Okay, look at that. That chicken is cooked perfectly. And remember, if you're using the regular rice, not the instant rice, then you're gonna cook it a little bit longer. All right, you want the first bite?
Sure.
Chicken and rice. I'm gonna go in for the rice and broccoli.
Mmm.
You like it? You gotta get your veggies.
Mm-hmm. Chicken,
super
rice.
Super easy. Super delicious.
Mm-hmm.
Using little smoky sausages. Spread those out. Now you're gonna take a can of Bush's baked beans or any brand you like. And that's just gonna go right over the top of our weenies. Sausages and beans are a great combination, and this is gonna make for a filling meal for a picky eater. Spread that out, and now I need some cheese. There's some cheddar on the top shelf.
Cheddar, I can get that. There you go. Cheddar, mild cheddar, got it.
Great. We're gonna just top that with some cheddar. There's lots of things in this that kids would like. And one good thing about the beans is that it's full of fiber. So that's why this is gonna be nice and filling. And you're getting your protein as well. So these weenies are great because kids love them too.
Yeah, these are great.
Ooh, yeah, they're perfect.
Weird, okay. Anyway.
So that we're also gonna add some biscuits. I'm gonna take these Grands biscuits and we're gonna just cut them into quarters. And that's gonna go over the top, just like that.
So these biscuits are just gonna go over top of the whole thing.
Yep, just like that. Somebody heard we were making dinner. Hi, Jax.
If I don't show him and it doesn't, it's not good.
Okay, so, but this is repetitive, so this is gonna go.
Okay.
And you just take your biscuits and cover all the top. And then when we pop this in the oven, these are gonna spread out and it's gonna be a nice casserole, quick and easy. And guess what? That's it.
That's it.
Simple, simple, delicious. You don't have to worry about spending hours making dinner, and I guarantee this will be a crowd pleaser.
Who doesn't love weenies?
All right, I'm excited. Our beanie weenies, is beanie that what we're weenies? Gonna call it? Our beanie weenie bake is ready. Now, I didn't let it cool like I normally do. I'm just gonna go ahead and taste it right out of the oven, so hopefully it don't burn my mouth.
Yeah, you don't wanna burn your mouth with a weenie. Just saying.
I swear.
All right,
here we go. Let's see. So our biscuits are nice and brown. I ended up keeping this in the oven for closer to 45 minutes. I initially thought it was only gonna be about 30, but the biscuits weren't quite brown yet. I covered it with some foil to keep them from getting too toasty. So just keep an eye on it. But I think it's time for the taste test.
All right.
So what we have in here are our cocktail weenies and the baked beans and some cheese covered in some biscuits.
All
okay,
right.
Here you go. Get that plate ready.
I'm ready.
So yeah, it is piping hot right now.
Yeah.
Yes.
Actually, it's going to be really good. If I burn my mouth, I blame y'all.
All right, here we go.
All right, got the beans, got the cheese, a little bit of everything, and a weenie, and a biscuit.
All right. Well,
it's really good.
Is it good?
If this is comfort food. Y'all, I'm not trying to convince you this is health food by any means. This is comfort food, quick and easy meal, and it's actually really delicious. It's a good combination. You want to try it?
Yes, absolutely.
I was going to have another bite, but here you go.
You take it first and I'll get it.